Welcome to raigurukul.com. In this video, we'll discuss about how to share or publish our Jira issue into Confluence pages without navigating it to Confluence. So we'll see here practically how we will do this. This is my Jira page where I've opened the issue EP14. If I want to publish this issue to Confluence page, definitely I need some interface. So if you can see here in my Confluence page, I have these pages are available. So if I want to create one more page for any particular issue, definitely I will go ahead with this. And from here, I will just click on publish to Confluence. Now I will get the recipe details here. So I will select the send to Confluence and click on next. Now here I have to define the page title. In which page title I want to publish it. So let me add it here, address page 3, click on submit, and this will take few seconds to make it available our detail on Confluence. So you can see this page is available. Either I will select through this, that is opening in new tab, as well as I will just refresh on Confluence and we'll have page 3 available. So simply I will click on address page 3. And that's it. We have the data available on Confluence. So as many details we want, we can do it. So we'll see here complete configurations detail in further part of video. So that's amazing feature available through elements, that is published to Confluence. So which is the activity created by elements team. So when we are working into any issue types and we want to publish some of the informations or we want to store some of the informations on Confluence page for audit perspective or for any mean of the requirement, then we will use element publish is add-on created by elements team. So we'll see here practically how to do it. While doing this, if you want to share the title, descriptions, attachments, then any comments, as well as the priority and severity of the issues, if we are publishing to create a document repository on Confluence, this will be helpful. So what we will achieve with this, by using element publish, we can create Confluence pages from Jira issue, control where and how we can trigger page creations, and embed issue details into Confluence template. So we'll see practically here. If you want to learn about Jira in detail, please watch my Jira playlist as well as Jira REST API. If you want to learn about Jira REST API. So for performing or publishing the content from Jira to Confluence, we have to navigate into the app sections. And from here, then click on explore more apps. Just search on element publish. Now we can see here element publish to Confluence create page from Jira. Click on this. This will navigate into the element marketplace and you can see here the company's detail. So this is the elements company which has created this add-on for Jira users to share their content on Confluence. Now let me hit start with the trial version. This will give us a 30-day trial period where we can create Confluence pages from Jira and insert our issue data, streamline the information flow, and use Jira Confluence together. This will also give us a flexibility to trigger page creation manually or automatically and copy issue data or attachments to page created, where we can use Confluence templates or design our own page. So we'll see here practically how we'll do it. Now this is installed. Let's navigate into the project sections. And once we will navigate into the project sections, we will have this issue list. As of now, I'm using AP board. If you can see here, this is my issue ID. So let me search it and open in detail descriptions. You can see here we have the title, descriptions, and some of the attachments are attached. I've also added the comment sections. So post that, we will have all this detail here. And once we'll see in the publish to Confluence, here we'll find out the options. So when we'll click on the publish to Confluence, it will navigate it to the pop-up options where it will search for the recipe. If you don't find it out any recipe, it won't be able to publish it. So primarily we have to create recipe. For creating a recipe, we have to navigate into the app sections and click on element publish. And here we'll have the options of publish administrations where we can see get started. So in get started sections, we can see create new recipe. At the time of creating a new recipe, click on create new recipe, specify the name. So let me specify the recipe name as send to Confluence. So this recipe name will be highlighted on the pop-up when we'll click on publish. Here we have source option from where we can select. So as of now, we are working on Avaya project. So I will select this. Issue types, we can select different issue types, but let's target on story. We can also select other issue types like subtask, status. As of now, I'm keeping it blank, but we can set different status screen as well. Additional filter, if you have any additional filter in terms of JQL, we can add it. Now we are having a target page where we can set our target. So in target page, we have to select our Confluence target page. So as of now, we can see here, my target page is brainstorming. So what I will do, I will select the Confluence page with this name. Maybe I will select this. And here we will have some pages. So not this one. Let's select this as a space and select brainstorming. If we will select the parent page, definitely the new page which is created for publishing our Jira issue, that will be created under brainstorming. If we will toggle this button, then it will override the existing pages, otherwise we'll keep the same. Publish on behalf of, so here we can set our publisher name or the admin. We will set the content. Once we'll select the content page, we can select different content from here. What options we can define to showcase that value. Now in title sections, we can keep even blank in content. If we want, we can add content page title according to our requirement. Otherwise, we can select any of the titles which is needed. So this will create a default title from here. So let's say I want to keep the title of reporter name, or because here we don't have any title fields are available. So let's say maybe we can keep the version detail. So fixed version detail, maybe we are keeping, or affected version detail if you are keeping, then I will select whatever the affected details version is available, that will add title. In page content, we can insert the value of page, what should be. So here we want to display description. So I will keep description here. Apart of that, I want assignee, then a reporter. So reporter is this, then priority field. After that, I want subtask or maybe summary. Otherwise, here we'll keep summary about defect. So let's insert this, remove the summary. Versions, we can keep it here. Affected versions, we'll keep here. Now we are, after that, if we want, we can use old Confluence editor. So on toggling this tab, attachments, if we want, we can add attachments as well. So inside this, we don't have attachments. So maybe enable copy attachment from the source to the Confluence page. We can copy it. Labels, if we want, we can copy it here. Now, as we discussed our design our own page, we can also select create from Confluence templates. So here we have Confluence templates available, which we can select it. Let's say if I'm selecting for else respective or retrospective, we will have complete templates available. We can also see the preview page on refreshing this click icon, and we can also add whichever options we need. So let's say I want to add few other details like approval, maybe approval detail, as well as some assignee, and then I want to add a final created or creator. Click on, then these details are also available inside this template. We can refresh the preview page and we will have these details updated here. So we have two options available: one, creation mode through design our own page, as well as we can create from Confluence templates. So this is also going to help us. And when we click on the next, now next, in trigger options, we'll have customized recipe availability. It, if enabled, the recipe can only be triggered in specific locations wherever we want. User restrictions, if we want to allow or disallow some set of user, that also we will do it. And public API is also available for this. So this is how we can create a recipe. Post creating this, we can save this process, and how this will help us to publish our content to Confluence, and how this will benefit to any user. So first, it will create a Confluence page from Jira issues, which is easy to use. Recipe let us to create Confluence pages with the issue data like the descriptions, text fields, label, and attachments from Jira, published alongside static content. Element published can even update our Confluence pages when Jira issue detail changes. So Jira Confluence are always in generate page titles dynamically based on the issue detail, like the summary key or reporter. No scripting or webhooks to configure. So if any project manager is handling a project which contains a data to be published on Confluence, so this will be very useful for tracking point of view. So no stress will be required for doing this activity. We can directly do it through Jira without going into Confluence. This will also control where and how we trigger page creations. So in project management, normally we create page from Jira with recipe that can be triggered manually or added as post functions to workflow transitions. We can control where and when recipe will be available by adding project issue types, priority, or additional GQL filters each recipe, or add conditions on the user like user identity or user group. We can also embed issue details in Confluence template with design our Confluence page using WYSI, WYG editor, and get the layout we need, or use one of the templates provided by Confluence. This is perfect to create postmortems, meeting notes, knowledge base articles, employee onboarding, or archive issue from complicated needs. And finally, if we want to automate this trigger process, we can also use it. So once we are done with creation of the recipe, we have to activate this. Without activating, we won't be able to proceed it. So as of now, it's activated. So we don't need to reactivate it. That's why we are moving ahead with the project sections, where we will open GAP address page, which contains the data of descriptions, summary detail, attachments, and one of the comments is available. We also have these details are available. Now, if I want to publish this information to Confluence, simply I will select publish to Confluence. And from here, we will get recipe options. So I will select this one because just now I've created sent to Confluence. Now, page title, I want to keep as summary. So exactly same thing is highlighted here. Click on submit. So this will take few seconds to send our informations or data into Confluence pages and generate the link for us. Now we can see address page generated. Here we will have all this detail which we have selected. So this is my descriptions, then creator name, assignee, and the next tab I am having as priority. So these are informations we have simply added from this ticket. So this is how this add-on is helping to minimize our effort for copying and pasting the Jira defect or Jira defect detail to Confluence pages. This will do it for us automatically. Even we can configure this add-on through our workflow. So whenever our workflow will trigger, it will automatically post this information. So this is how it is minimizing the effort of any project management team or any person who is working on Jira, pasting the detail and creating a document repository on Confluence. So that's all from this video. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think we have better option than this, or we can add better use case on element published, then probably you can add the comment in comment box. So that's all from this video. Hope you enjoyed the thing. If you think so, this will be useful. Don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.